Yeah, let's get this show started, because we got to talk about Diddy. Didn't I tell y'all Diddy going to have some new evidence on these people that was in the party with him? Yeah, we got to talk about this. Yeah, we got to talk. We're going to break this down quick. We got to talk about this, y'all, because I told people Diddy is not going to get charged for everything. They're going to hit him with something. Pause. They're going to get charged for something. Allegedly, they're going to charge him for something. But the things that people think he's going to get charged with, that's not going to happen. And we're going to talk about this. Smash that like button. Subscribe to the channel, man. Everything I speak on this video is a legend. Y'all see that thumbs up? Smash that like button, man. It ain't going to hurt. And it ain't going to cost you. That junk is free. Smash that like. Let's get this show started, though, man. Yo. If they know, they know. It's your boy, Smoke News TV. We back here with another video. Smash the like button, man. Subscribe to the channel if you haven't, because I don't know what you're waiting on, to be honest. Make sure that notification bell on so you know when I'm dropping my video. And share this video, by the way. Share the video. But most importantly, smash the like button. And a big shout out to all my members that got their membership. They got their badge, man. Shout out to them. Team Smoke and Smoke Gang. And shout out to all y'all that's been showing me love and subscribing to the channel also. So big shout out to all y'all, man. But we got to talk about this Diddy. Matter of fact, let's get this copyright out the way, because we got to talk about this. Copyright fair use disclaimer. You can find that in my description on my channel, on this channel. Everything that I speak on over here is for educational entertainment purpose. Again, copyright fair use disclaimer. You can find it in my description on my channel. Everything that I speak on over here is for educational entertainment purpose. The clips and videos I play are also owned by the original creators. So we got that out the way, because we're going to get straight to this. Didn't I tell y'all Diddy was gonna, in my old Diddy video, when this junk first happened, pause, I told y'all, man, Diddy got a lot of things that's gonna kind of have this case a little shaky. The video's okay, that's another thing, but he got an NDA contract that everybody that was coming to the after hour party and all that, whatever, to the party, you know, the free call party and all that, he had an NDA contract on these people, and they had to put their signature on there. You know, they had to give up the phones, all that. So that tells me y'all people knew what y'all was walking into. Y'all knew what y'all was walking into. This room got this. This room over here doing this. Upstairs room doing that. This doing this. All this little foolery and all this little freak-off thing that's going on. Y'all people knew what y'all was walking into. Y'all knew what y'all was, because there's an NDA contract involved in this. Oh, y'all did. I know y'all been seeing it. If y'all haven't seen, check this out. Yeah, check this out. Diddy's alleged NDA for his party's release. Agreement reportedly lasts for the life of the artist plus 20 years after his death. The artist mean Diddy, if y'all kind of confused. That's him. So you can't talk crazy while he's alive. And if he died, you got to wait 20 years to talk crazy about this nigga. This nigga got a whole NDA contract involved all in his free calls. Ain't that smart? Because he on some Nino Brown. If I go down, all y'all coming down with me, nigga. Let's get to that part. Allegedly, and everything I speak on is alleged. But that's exactly what I've been saying. Now, as far as the video, the cameras, we don't know if these people actually knew they was getting recorded now. We don't know that. That's a whole different ball game right there we're talking at. But as far as the NDA, the baby oil, all that shit that was in it, these people knew. All these celebrities that was walking in there, they knew what they was walking into. That's why he had that NDA goddamn contract involved. Go up, man. I'm telling you, Diddy ain't dumb. Diddy alleged standard NDA for his studio session release. Signs not allowed to give interviews, write books, and otherwise disseminate information about Diddy. He got NDAs from the parties and studio. Because remember when people said they was in the studio, it was like, yo, world up, you know, that nigga, you know, the girls talking all crazy, that, you know, was a lot of shit going on in the studio and all that. This nigga had NDAs from the studio, from the free calls, and Lord knows what other NDAs he had. So you telling me when you had a female artist come into the daddy house, whatever, you know, that Diddy on the Diddy on studio down there in Manhattan, whatever, you telling me Diddy told these people or somebody around Diddy security, because obviously if Diddy don't tell him, security gonna tell him. Before you walk in here, you gotta sign this NDA contract. That part, what do we talk about? Ain't that spooky? That's nasty work. That's why a lot of these people ain't coming out talking so much. That's why a lot of them are talking behind the phone, pause. That's why a lot of them ain't showing their face from male to female with all these allegations going on Diddy. I told y'all, this is bigger than this. This got something to do, allegedly, and everything I speak on is alleged. This got something to do with that goddamn liquor company, the big liquor company that he was with, the Ciroc and all that, that liquor company, pardon me, across seas. The one I told y'all about, the one that everybody's speaking about. That family. Remember, he put the lawsuit on the liquor company because he felt like they was being racist towards Diddy. Because Diddy done worked with them for so many years. But Diddy, you making $60 million a year off your Ciroc, my nigga. And we all thought that was your damn drink. And it comes to find out it wasn't. You was just a big promoter for it when it first came out. But you made 60, damn near 70 a mil. I done did this video. Check my Diddy videos. Go check them out when this first happened. I talked about the liquor company and all that. That turned around and said, oh, you want to sue us? Oh, okay, we got something for you because we made you. We didn't make you in the hip-hop world, but nigga, we made you in this liquor on world that we got you on involved in, and you making 60, 70 a million. How dare you say that we racist? Now, the reason why Diddy went crazy, because George Clooney, if y'all know who George Clooney is, the actor, infamous actor, good actor and all that, I rock with George. Shout out to George Clooney, man. For real, shout out to him. But George Clooney, the one that came out with that Casamigo liquor and all that, he sold that shit for crazy mills. They invested in that Casamigo drink and all that before Diddy had that other drink he was trying to come out. What was it? Dolly on or some shit like that. Pardon me if I'm pronouncing it wrong, but y'all know what drink that Diddy was pushing. They pushed the Casamigo before they did that. That's why Diddy got mad. Because Diddy like, damn, I've been rocking with y'all for damn near 15 years. George Clooney jumping the scene. Y'all snatch him up. Y'all invest in his liquor. Next thing you know, he blows up and sell that shit for like a crazy hundreds of millions of dollars. That was George Clooney liquor, just to let y'all know. Yeah, that was his shit. He sold it for hundreds of millions of dollars. They was all down with the same liquor company. It's a big family. And when you messing with people like that, what you think gonna happen when you trying to put a goddamn lawsuit on them and then the lawsuit is accusing them being racist? That's the most worst shit you could try to put out there. And if y'all want to see the video where he talking about it, y'all can go to YouTube or go check my old Diddy video. I played a clip of it when he's talking about the liquor company and all that. But see, Diddy got to understand, bro. You can't play like that with people like that, man. You just can't. That's why they got him in a hot seat the way he is now. Pause. But I'm going to tell you one thing. Cassie, I knew she was a joke, allegedly, and everything I speak on is alleged. And I don't condone what Diddy did to on that camera that we seen Diddy put hands and feet on him. I don't condone that. But see, there's rumors out there, allegedly, circulating in the internet and all in the air, saying that she liked to drink and do, you know, she liked to do her little, how I could say this, she liked to do her little drugs, a little on party drugs. We're going to say it that way. Pardon me, y'all. We're going to say it that way. She like to do a little party drugs, whatever. Oh, y'all think I'm lying? Remember Dirty Money, the two girls, the two group that was down with Bad Boy, down with Diddy? This is one of them talking about it. Peep this out. Smash that like button, subscribe to the channel. You see the thumbs up? Smash that like button, ladies and gentlemen. It's free. Ain't going to hurt or cost you. Light one up. Y'all already know the vibes, man.
Sean has always been somebody that I wanted to be like.
Cassie.
Lover to death, naive, like getting high. She likes partying. She liked that. What was the thing?
Speaking of the after party.
I don't fucking know. Don't talk about no baby oil, man. Like, I still use baby oil. Y'all need to get into it. I saw Cassie grow up from a little girl that was willing to, like, give everybody motherfucking, you know, lap dances, basically. You know, and get drunk and just have a good, like, model time.
What's your relationship like with Dawn?
I don't fuck with Dawn like that. And I'm gonna fucking stand on business. I didn't see that. What I saw was, what the fuck is going on with you? Because you acting weird. You're a weird bitch, is what I seen. And it's a list of niggas. Where y'all at? Talk about it. Dawn's a weird motherfucker, man. But y'all motherfuckers call me to tell the truth.
She's talking about Dawn. For the people that know these two, Diddy had a group called Dirty Money. It was them two. Dawn and this lady right here. Dawn is like, she just talking crazy. She's coming out saying, saying her part, pardon me, ganja, pardon me. But she's coming out talking about Dawn, and then she talked about Cassie a little bit. That's the reason why I had to play that clip. Because I kind of believe that Cassie probably was a little loose cannon, jumping on people's laps and all this. I could see that type of shit going on at that NDA party that they had going on, because they had to sign a contract. They had to go by that NDA contract. I told y'all, Diddy wasn't going out without a fight, man. And his lawyers got contracts with people's signature, knowing about this NDA shit, knowing what they was walking into, knowing what kind of rooms they was walking into, knowing that once they walked through them goddamn doors, they knew his party was on. They knew what he was walking into. That's smart that Diddy did that. Let's get to that part. But as far as the video, that's something else now. Totally something else. Now, if they know about the videos being in the, because listen, let me tell y'all something. When you go to a mansion like a Diddy, any man, they see cameras all around the house and all that shit. So these people see the cameras up, bro. So the cameras got to be part of the NDA contract too. That part. What are we talking about here? Because you're not going to tell me you walk in the house, you don't see cameras on the corner of the house and all that. Okay, the hidden ones, the ones that's hidden low key, that's something else. But when you walking through the hallways and all that, come on, all these rich niggas got cameras in their house and shit like that. They knew what they was getting themselves into, man. I'm telling y'all, it's just bigger than this, man. But let's continue. Smash that like button, subscribe to the channel, share this video.
People didn't talk about the Diddy parties, these freak-offs, because he made them sign a huge NDA agreement that has just been revealed.
Now, peep this out. Peep this out. This is the reason why you're Jay-Z's allegedly, and everything I say, speak on is alleged. This is the reason why you're Jay-Z's and all these other own people. The reason why I'm just throwing Hov there, because, you know, that's my man, too. I rock Hov. Don't get it twisted. But come on, Hov. I hope you wasn't in them free calls, champ. I hope you wasn't in them free calls, man. You and Dane been going. You and Dane Dash. That's why Dane been talking about this shit on his network. Shout out to you, Dane, because I rock with you. And I know you watch my bitch. Shout out to you, Dane. I rock with you. This is, respectfully, you said you don't know nothing about the after-hour parties. This is what you said, Dane. In your little interview, you said you don't know nothing about the after hour party. Okay, I'm gonna believe you on that. But it's hard for me to believe that, bro. It's very hard for me to believe you ain't know about these after parties and all this, that shit. And you telling me that you just turned your back over the door, walked off type shit. That's hard for me to believe. Now, you saying you never did, and you hoping that Jay-Z wasn't part of that after party freak off activities, illegal shit that was going on, that these allegations on Diddy now. You said you hope Hov ain't involved in that. We hoping that shit too, because that shit will crush hip hop. I'm going to keep it real with you. If we find out Hov is some type of shit that Diddy was doing, that shit will crush hip hop. No lie. People look at hip hop like, God, they'll be like, yo, what? You got Hov up there doing? And we all know about the whole situation of Beyonce, how old she was, and this and that. You know, there's a lot of rumors and speculations and allegations and all this. We already know about it. We know about that. But the woman ended up being his goddamn wife at the end of the day. So we can't really speak about what age he met Beyonce and all that. Okay, whatever. That's his business. But as far as the freak-off situation with the NDA, there's so many celebrities and hip-hop and politicians, probably, and Hollywood people and all types of people, signatures on them contracts is what I'm trying to tell y'all. NBA players, football players, all types of people, man. I told y'all Diddy wasn't going without a goddamn fight. I told y'all this, man. He's not going to. I'm just sorry to tell y'all. Or for the people that were, oh, man, Diddy going to get smoked. Yeah, you know, Diddy going to do like 50 years. I'm sorry to tell y'all that ain't going to happen. That ain't going to happen. Because that NDA contract going to help him so much. Because if his lawyer's obviously going to be great. Diddy got money. They're gonna say the same thing I'm saying, but they're gonna say it in a way better way, and they're gonna eat that prosecutor alive. Pause. They're gonna tell it like, listen, these people knew what they was walking into. But let's continue. Smash that like button. Subscribe to the channel, man. Listen to old girl. Gotta say on this.
People didn't talk about the Diddy parties, these freak-offs, because he made them sign a huge NDA agreement that has just been revealed. So much is coming out about these parties now, and a ton of people are coming forward, but we all know there are a lot more that attended these parties, were victimized at these parties, or at least saw these parties taking place. He made everyone sign this NDA, and in this, it states that no one can photograph, film, or record Diddy or anyone in his inner circle without his consent. No one was allowed to make any social media posts about his parties unless he signed off on it. And no interviews, books, or info at all about Diddy or his parties unless he specifically signed off on it in writing. And this NDA that people signed was to last the life of Diddy plus 20 years after his death, or a total of 70 years, whichever lasted longer.
Diddy, now he ain't going out without a fight, man.
Diddy's party NDA revealed, guests are strictly forbidden from revealing anything about him or those in his inner circle. Strict NDA requirements. Attendees at Diddy's parties must sign a non-disclosure agreement that prohibits them from sharing any information about Diddy, his family, friends, business associates, or current and former partners. No photography or recording. The NDA specifically bars attendees from taking photos, filming, or recording anything at the event without Diddy's written consent. This includes sharing images or videos on social media. Long-lasting NDA. The agreement lasts for either the lifetime of Diddy plus 20 years or a total of 70 years, whichever is longer. This is an unusually lengthy term for an NDA. Restrictions on publications. Attendees are not allowed to give interviews, write books, or release any information about Diddy or his parties without prior written approval. In my opinion, this NDA is very suspicious.
Diddy got NDAs on the parties. Diddy had NDAs in the studio sessions. I mean, yo, bro, Diddy ain't dumb. He's like, listen, y'all niggas ain't gonna come because you gotta understand, Diddy went through certain shit back in the days. Hold up, let's pump this break right quick before I continue. Smash that goddamn like button. Y'all see that thumbs up? Smash the like button, subscribe to the channel because I don't know what you're waiting on, but smash the like button. Share this video too. But back what I was saying with Diddy. Diddy, I told people this in my old Diddy videos. I said, yo, he's not going to go out like that. He ain't going out like them old school niggas back in the day because a lot of NDA shit be happening nowadays. And that shit been going on for decades now. When you go to certain parties, do certain things, these people that got money like this, they got NDA contract. You can't bring your phone in and nothing. We doing straight 90s party up here, nigga. 80s, nigga. Ain't no phone, ain't no, you ain't taking no photos, no selfies, none of that. We ain't doing that. And I got all y'all signatures for the people that was coming in the house. You know how many signatures he got? You know how many NDA contracts and signatures that Lord knows is on that goddamn list? I'm sorry to tell y'all, Diddy ain't getting charged for everything. Now, as far as the drugs and the underage girls and underage people, whatever kids you want, I'm going to say kids, whatever, underage, whatever, male and female, that's something they actually going to have to prove in that court. Video, the witnesses. Oh, let's get to the witnesses. Remember they say they had 120 and more witnesses that's going to step up and all this. They're going to come to the feds and all this, but they was calling a hotline instead because you know why? They don't want to show their face because they're part of that NDA contract. That part. Let that marinate in y'all brain and y'all soul. Why you think ain't so many goddamn celebrities been coming out talking about this? Why you think ain't so many victims coming out either? NDA contracts. Smoke, but we can hear them. They've been talking though, you know, this audio. That's all. You can hear them talk. But we don't know who the hell's the people. Them people don't even want to show their goddamn face. Because when they shove this NDA contract, they're gonna be like, what are you talking about? Your signature's right down here in the bottom of this NDA contract, sir, miss. That part. Diddy got him. Let's continue though. Smash that like button, subscribe to the channel, man.
The day will come when we will name names other than Sean Combs, and there's a lot of names. It's a long list already. And of course, I already know who some of these individuals are, but because of the nature of this case, we're gonna make damn sure that we're right before we do that. But the names that we're going to name, assuming that our investigators confirm and corroborate what we've been told, are names that will shock you. The day will come when we...
The name's going to shock us. Names on the list. Names on the NDA contract list. They got all that now, man. Y'all, that lady just showed y'all. Y'all think I'm bluffing over here lying. Go do y'all research. It's an NDA list. It's out there right on the internet. You can see it yourself and Google this shit. Nigga had a contract on it. He had an NDA contract on his party. That shit is very helpful for you. As a millionaire, a global, a global, a mogul, all that. For a nigga like Diddy, that shit is helpful. Very helpful for any individual that throw parties like that. Because now you can shove that in their face like, y'all knew what y'all was coming into. Y'all knew what y'all was walking into. Let's get to that part. Yeah, y'all know about the baby oil and all that shit. It ain't a shock to a lot of people that signatures is on that NDA. Let's go to the 120 witness, though. Remember the hotline? People was calling all of this. Oh, I'm a victim. I'm a victim. Yeah, I'm a victim, too. I'm a victim. I'm a victim, too. Different type of genders was calling this shit. But then nobody never want to show their face. Now, remind y'all, the fans say they got to come to them. How are we going to build a case up? How are we going to build this case? Very big case on them that we got 120 witnesses we could use, but none of y'all don't want to come forward to us on a one-on-one conversation. Oh, y'all think I'm lying? Peep this out. Smash that like button. Subscribe to the channel, man.
Diddy update. His lawyers arguing to the judge that the government should be required to identify the victims in the case. So first off, under the federal rules of criminal procedure, the defendant has the right at any time before arraignment or 14 days after arraignment to ask the government to provide a bill of particulars. What's that? A more specific set of information concerning the claims and the charges made by the government against the defendant. In this case, we know what the charges are. We know who one of the victims are. But if you read the indictment, there could be God knows how many victims. And defense argues, we don't know who any of these people are. They need to tell us, because if they don't tell us, how are we going to prepare a defense? They argue that, hey, look, there's civil lawsuits coming out of everywhere. Everyone and their mother is claiming that Diddy sexually assaulted them. A lawyer in Houston's got a hotline going with more than 1,200 people calling in a 24-hour period, and he says 120 of them are going to file a lawsuit. How can we possibly start to defend and prepare our defense if we don't know which particular victims the government is talking about?
What will the judge do? Not at all clear. One thing I do know, given what the judge said at the initial conference, this case is going to move fast. He is ready to rule. I expect the government will issue their response in a couple of days. And then maybe by the end of the month, possibly sooner, you'll hear from the judge on whether the names of the victims will be revealed. The fact that the defense is making this motion and the fact that the defense made that other motion seeking an evidentiary hearing based on alleged illegal grand jury leaks tells you they're getting ready for a trial.
They ready for a trial, man. And the judge is telling them, like, listen, y'all got 120 goddamn victims down there. Tell them to come forward. How are we going to build this case heavy on this nigga Pauls? Only thing y'all doing is calling the hotline and shit. But y'all not meeting with the feds and the people that's building the case on Diddy. That part, what are we talking about? I'm telling y'all right now, man, they probably going to have like one or two goddamn witnesses on that stand, man. That's it. I'm telling y'all, because, yo, you got to have multiple people say they victims. That's number one. All the people that from male to females that said that Diddy did this, Diddy did that in the studio with them studio session. That nigga had an NDA in the studio. The nigga had an NDA contract for his free calls and studio set in the studio, too. Come on, man. This is crazy. Diddy ain't dumb. He ain't the only thing they get hit him with. They're gonna hit him if he don't get found guilty on the heavy on the most heaviest charges, Pauls, on the ones they trying to smack him with. They gonna get him with something light plus time served. Why you think Diddy's sitting in there for a while now? By time this trial started in May, which it supposed to start in May. Nigga, he been sitting there for mad months. That's almost going on a year after May. Think about that. Let that marinate. I'm trying to tell y'all, Diddy gonna end up getting the bell soon, probably before the holidays or after the holidays. If not, he gonna be sitting in there for a while. That's all time served. With no witnesses, they got 120 witnesses claiming victim down in Houston, all this, but nobody's coming up really. Who they witnesses? Now we gotta talk about reliable witness. Oh, they got Cassie, man. Listen, they gonna, you don't think Diddy gonna have his people taking up for him going up there saying, yo, man, Cassie, well, she was on drugs and alcohol, all types of shit. You don't think they're gonna say that? Alleged, and everything I speak on is alleged. You think they ain't gonna say that though? You think Diddy's side ain't gonna be coming up for it? Diddy got niggas on his back too, in the back end. That part, them niggas is coming forward for him. People, artists, all that. Come on, certain people. Because they don't want to get exposed on that NDA either. That part, what are we talking about? So a lot of people might switch up. Like, damn, this nigga got them, they got the NDA contract. Man, my name on them, the signature. Man, I'm about to go slide over here and go on Diddy's side. I'm about to go slide over here and go on Diddy's side because of that NDA contract. And the list that they got with all the people being at the freak-offs. That's why that dude, now y'all gonna hear this. I'm gonna play it one more time. Pete, what he's saying. He's saying he don't want to come forward and start talking about the people on the list until he get real good evidence and all this. No, nigga. That's that NDA contract and them people on the list is trying to pay people off like, yo, do not say my name. There's some powerful people on that list probably. Peep this out, man. Let this marinate in your brain.
The day will come when we will name names other than Sean Combs, and there's a lot of names.
The day will come. Now, will, the day will mean that it ain't coming tomorrow, pause. That shit could be 10 years from now. It'd be different if he say, oh, yeah, you know, by next month, by 90 days, whatever, we'll say some names, and I mean, besides Sean Combs, besides Diddy. Now, if he would have said by like 90 days and this or that's a problem now. But he said a day will come. That shit could be 20 years from now because of the NDA contract. Peep that out, right? Let's go back.
The day will come when we will name names other than Sean Combs, and there's a lot of names. It's a long list already. And of course, I already know who some of these individuals are, but because of the nature of this case, we're going to make damn sure that we're right before we do that. But the names that we're going to name, assuming that our investigators confirm and corroborate what we've been told, are names that will shock you. The day will come when we...
Come on, man. People getting paid, man. These people, you got to understand, these are some millionaires on that list. Billionaires on that list. There's some powerful people, alleged, on that list. And on an NDA contract list with signatures on there. What are we talking about here, man? Take that ain't gonna do 50 or 30 joints. See, R. Kelly's a different story because they got R. Kelly urinating on a goddamn underage girl on video. Y'all remember that? That's a throwback for all y'all youngers that don't know about that one. There's an old video of R. Kelly. This is when I was young. I was in my late, I had to been what, 19? This is before, this is like 2000 around there, 99, some shit like that. This nigga got a whole videotape of himself urinating on an underage girl, R. Kelly. That shit went viral and everything. That shit went viral so much, that shit ended up adapting to the DVD era, that part. What are we talking about here? That shit was on the VH1 tapes. DVD came, nigga, the R. Kelly shit still out, nigga. That's what smoked them. When they got video of you doing some shit like that to an underage girl and all these other allegations R. Kelly was getting accused, they got a video of that nigga. Now, we got a video of Diddy putting hands and feet on Cassie, but she's not an underage woman, a girl. She's a woman. She grown. She been with Diddy for 15 goddamn years since she was young. That's why old girl said, man, Cassie like to get drunk, do a little drugs, and jump on niggas' laps. Alleged. The girl from the Dirty Money Group. I'm not saying her thing is all facts, but man, look, if she was partying with them, she know what the hell going on. She on Diddy's side. What y'all gonna say? Oh, nah, she looks spaced out. This man, listen, I don't care how she looks. She was there, that part. What are we talking about? This woman right here? Let's replay and go back one more time.
Sean has always been somebody that I wanted to be like.
Cassie.
Lover to death, naive, like getting high. She likes partying. She liked that. It was a thing.
Speaking of the after party.
I don't fucking know. Don't talk about no baby oil, man. Like, I still use baby oil. Y'all gonna get into it. I saw Cassie grow up from a little girl that was willing to, like, give everybody motherfucking, you know, lap dances, basically. You know, get drunk and just have a good, like, model time.
What's your relationship like with Dawn?
See? Cassie liked to get drunk. You know, everybody loved her. She was the party. She was the party. She was the party of the party, nigga. That's what old girl said. Y'all people got to forget. Go do y'all research on Dirty Money. It was the two females. It was Dirty Money. It was Dawn and her. Her and Dawn right now, they beefing. She talking about Dawn saying Dawn is bugged out, too. A lot of niggas need to come forward and say that girl's bugged out. I played this clip earlier. Go check it out. Just played it a couple, like, 20 minutes ago, whatever. But anyway, you heard what she said about Cassie, right? Come on, man. And it's a whole bunch of other people that's going to come out and say the same shit about Cassie. You was with that man for 15 years. Why didn't you leave? Come on, man. Because you always thought you wanted to be famous. You wanted to be super famous and everything. I'm telling you, that famous boy, that... Being famous, boy, it's a killer thing, man. It's contagious, man. That, like, it'll feed on to you when you next to another famous person. You want to be there so bad, and you'll do anything that's possible to try to get there. That's the way it sounded like with Cassie and a whole other bunch of female people that was on under these labels. Because Diddy ain't the only label. There's plenty of other labels too that did a lot of crazy shit, allegedly. And everything I speak on, it's alleged. But back to the NDA contract, like I told y'all, Diddy's not going to get smoked the way we think he's going to get smoked. Nah. NDA contracts mean a lot in court. Jury's going to look back like, man, y'all people knew what the hell y'all was walking into. That part. What are we talking about here? Well, nah, they probably don't got everything on the contract. Man, listen, I ain't trying to hear that. You should have spoke about this shit the next day and went to the goddamn police. What we talking about here? For the people that wasn't famous in that goddamn party. Come on, man. I don't know, y'all. I want to hear y'all opinion, y'all smoke, man. Make sure y'all comment it below. Give me y'all theory about this. Because I had to make a quick video about this. Because that NDA shit going to help Diddy a lot. Nigga got NDAs in the studio contract. He got NDAs in the parties, all types. He got, Lord knows what other NDAs he got contract on. Know what I mean? Like, that shit gonna help him, though. Because a lot of people that just jumping off the porch trying to get money out of Diddy, too. We gotta think about that. We can't say every person is a victim. A lot of people are money hungry, trolling, trying to get the bag. They trying to do anything to get the bag necessary. If a girl could try to figure out, like, yo, I could try to figure out that I was at that party, whatever, and make them believe me, she's going to try to go get that goddamn bag to change her life. What are we talking about here? And she could be a baddie, but she ain't never been there in Diddy parties her goddamn life, but she's going to act like she was, though. That's the things you got to watch, too, you know what I mean? It's a lot of hungry people trying to get money off of Diddy. But that NDA contract going to help them a lot. A lot. Well, I want to hear your opinion, man. Comment it below. Give me y'all smoke. Give me y'all theory on this. Y'all think the NDA contract going to help? Because obviously with the NDA contract, there's a lot of senators with famous people on there that don't want to come out now. Not even famous. B-list actors. I mean, B-list celebrities, A-list celebrities, and C-list celebrities. None of them don't want to talk because of the senator on the NDA. The NDA probably got all types of shit. People don't even read contracts. What are we talking about here? That shit probably said, man, there's baby oil in this room. There's shit going on in this room. Man, listen, you think people sat there after drinking after a regular party? You think they read that shit before they walked in? They just signed the shit and walk in. Don't know what's on that list, though. That part. Let that marinate in y'all brain, which I just told y'all. Don't know what's on the contract. That's like you signing a contract and a label and you don't read a whole contract. That part. That's what I'm trying to explain. You just happy. You excited. Like, man, fuck, I'm about to get famous. You signed your life away. So it goes vice versa. You think they had time to read a goddamn NDA contract while they trying to go in this goddamn party and like, man, listen, man, they signed your goddamn name. Let's go, man. That's what them people did. They didn't read it. Who's going to read that shit while they toxic? Party, it's party time. It's rich people. They ain't got time to be reading that shit. They just going to sign their signature and walk in. All right, we in a Diddy party. Let's go. That's what them people did. I just broke it down the perfect way for y'all. That's like signing a label. That's like signing anything. You don't read that shit. They did the same thing with the NDA contract. They didn't read that shit. They didn't know what's in that contract. They don't know what's on that. They don't know nothing. They just sign there, walk right in, nigga. Party time. Let's go. That's what them people did. And that's smart on Diddy behalf. So think about that. Let that marinate. Comment below. Give me your theory about that, though, man. Diddy smart on this, on that NDA contract. I'm not going to lie. He was smart on that. A lot of people on there. But smash that like button. Subscribe to the channel. It's your boy Smoke News TV, man. Do me a favor. Smash that like. Share this video and subscribe. I'm up out of here, man. It's your boy Smoke News TV. If they know, they know. Salute, gang. I'm out of here.